Last week, after the Dominaria leak occurred, Blake Rasmussen laid out the new release schedule for articles and information relating to the set, which was set to start yesterday with the mechanics and rules articles. Instead, yesterday, an article was posted to the Magic homepage by Aaron Forsyth with a revised schedule. After some community feedback, Wizards has decided to wait a bit longer to go in depth about the new set. The mechanics and rules articles will be posted next week, Wednesday, March 21st, which will also be the day that the first Magic story for Dominaria will go live. As an added bonus, Forsyth revealed Phyrexian Scriptures, one of the new saga cards from Dominaria, which features portrait artwork and a small addition to the frame on the left-hand side of the card to help with the progression of the chapter abilities. Along with the shift in Dominaria information, Masters 25 also makes a move, and you'll be able to play the new set early on Magic Online. Originally scheduled for release after next week's downtime, Masters 25 will now release on Magic Online a week early, starting after tomorrow's downtime. This will also change Pauper, as all cards that are newly printed at Common will be legal in the format, starting with the Masters 25 release tomorrow. That's not all that's going on in Magic Online, though, as tonight starts the first of two nights of Team Modern Super League. Last week, a travel issue coming back from the Magic Online Championships caused a weekly Super League broadcast to be canceled. And in order to make up for the lost event, there will now be episodes of the Super League both tonight and tomorrow. Once a month, Magic Online hosts two pods for the Streamer Showdown, featuring Magic Online streamers facing off against each other. This month's Streamer Showdown will only have one pod starting at 1 p.m., but will feature Travis Sowers, Amaz, Loading Ready Run, Jim Davis, Gabby Spartz, Kenji Igashira, Matt Bedsole, and Jamie Topples drafting Masters 25. The annual Gamma Trade Show is being held this week in Reno, Nevada, and yesterday at the show, WizKids revealed an upcoming Magic board game and line of minis. Originally only seen on an advertisement at Toy Fair earlier this year, we now have more information on the Magic the Gathering Heroes of Dominaria board game. The Euro-style game is designed for 2 to 4 players who will visit various locations in Dominaria, including Llanowar, Urborg, and Keld, in order to gather resources needed to save the multiverse before the other players do. There will also be two versions of Heroes of Dominaria released, a standard version and a premium version, which will include 4 pre-painted minis of iconic Magic heroes. The board game is slated for launch in August of this year. WizKids also revealed a new series of token creatures in Magic the Gathering Creature Forge Overwhelming Swarm. The set of 28 tokens will cover known creature types from throughout Magic's history. The bases of the tokens will feature the 5 colors of Magic, with unique bases for artifacts and multicolored creatures. The bases will also feature game stats, so the tokens can be used during gameplay. The first set of Magic the Gathering Creature Forge Overwhelming Swarm is expected to release in July of this year. That's our show for today, March 13th. Make sure to like and subscribe to our channel to keep up with all the latest Magic news and strategy. I'm Jeremy Knoll, and this has been Split Second.